pay your rent when you're on the verge of eviction? Who will dare challenge their brutality when it leaks to our dear citizens? Who will protect you from the big bad wolf?
You don't need protection from the big bad wolf.
Bigby? Miss White?
Excuse me, dear.
I wanted to make sure I had the chance to say something.
How can
you? Why don't you take a moment to catch your breath?
What's she doing here?
Stop talking to her.
I'd like to... I need to say something.
We're kind of in the middle of something.
Bluebeard.
What?
You don't need to do this.
You don't have to do this.
Yes, I do. You probably don't remember me. I don't know why I was afraid to come here.
My dear, I don't...
Just shut up! You enslaved us for years. Let us hear stories about what you do. Told us we would lose everything if we stepped just one toe out of line. And we couldn't say a word about it because of these damn ribbons. But you know what? Now it's my turn to talk.
Because... What's her name? Died. The magic from the ribbon is gone, right? So now she can say whatever she wants. She could take the ribbon. I don't know if she should take the ribbon off. Maybe just leave it on for the rest of your life, just in case. But apparently now, she can say whatever she wants, because the one who created the ribbons is dead, so the power is gone out of them. Makes sense. I didn't consider that.
How are you?
I found Vivian's body.
Vivian, that's her name.
Did you kill her? Did he?
Indirectly.
Sheriff, this is highly irregular.
Be quiet.
We need to establish some order here.
She wanted you all freed.
Vivian wanted you freed from the ribbons. She took her own life.
I'm sorry, I don't think
Nerissa.
I know your...
My name is Nerissa.
It's okay, my dear. It's going to be just...
He ordered them dead. This fucker. Faith and Lily...
That's a lie.
I was in the goddamn room when he did it. Faith and Lily are dead because of you. The only two people who ever gave a damn about me. And now I can finally say, you're an asshole. And I hope you rot at the bottom of the witching well.
Worse than well. This confirms it.
And this just confirms it.
He made Georgie do it. It was always him. Georgie would have never done anything without his say-so. Ever.
Went in the crowd.
You're going to take the word of a stupid...
At least five other girls will back me up on this. We all heard you say it.
She better get away from him.
Did you now?
Looks like we found our evidence.
She saw it firsthand.
He's guilty.
Good enough for me.
Me too.
He's gonna attack her.
That's it, right?
Calm down the witching well.
Nah, that's too fucking easy for a crook like that.
What do you mean?
He's gotta pay for what he did.
Listen to yourselves!
You're all rats, fleeing from one sinking ship to the next. So quick to latch onto whatever will keep your miserable lives afloat. This is how you want to repay all I've done for you.
What, you take two people's lives away and now you want mercy?
You know we can't let you go free after this.
Wait!
You're done talking.
You're done talking, crooked man. You had your chance.
Well done, then.
Now, for your sentence.
We don't have to become murderers.
What are you talking about?
He's guilty. I know that, but we don't have to kill anybody. We can imprison him. Lock him up forever. Somewhere he can never hurt anyone again.
How can we be sure he won't escape?
I can help. We'll use magic.
That's not good enough.
Maybe there will be more if he isn't stopped.
Hasn't there been enough
bloodshed already? So we get rid of him.
Oh, shut up.
Everyone, listen up.
My God.
Clearly, we're having trouble agreeing on a suitable punishment.
Yeah.
So I think
this is going nowhere.
Someone needs to make a decision.
Who?
I hope you aren't suggesting yourself.
Why not?
What about a vote?
What do you think this
is? Yeah.
Everyone, calm down.
We should vote.
We should have a vote. Make it democratic.
Do you really think that's going to work?
He's right.
Sure.
Nobody can agree on anything. What about Bigby?
Then vote. Majority
what
rules.
What about him? He was appointed. He's the only official representative, really. He should be the judge.
What about the vote?
That makes sense to me.
I guess it does.
Okay.
Fine.
What
are
about
sure?
the vote?
This isn't how it's
what the people want,
Mr. Don't all have to agree? Isn't it unanimous?
Mr. Wolf, it's your call.
Vote.
No.
Just do what you think is right.
Take a vote. Majority rules vote.
Yes, Sheriff. do what you think is right.
Teach him a fucking lesson.
No.
He has to die.
We can lock him
just
away.
Just fucking get rid of him.
Not this way.
Whoa. I took too long. Oh. Get him down the well now. Bye.
There you are. I hope you all remember this moment.
Oh, believe me. I will.
Finish it, Sheriff.
You know, just between us, I was gonna let you live. But now...
You're going to miss me.
Nah, I was gonna throw him down the well anyway. Boop.
No, I won't.
Fabletown will remember that. What's this, Alright, so we're missing one for five. And two more. What we got? Fabletown Justice. When a criminal is captured in Fabletown, the traditional procedure is to hold a formal hearing in front of the community or concerned parties. However, exceptions are often made to expedite the process. Yes, all the way down to the bottom. If there is one. In reality, there aren't any hard and fast rules for these types of situations, and the extent to which policies are upheld can depend on who is being charged. And will they try to kill the, judge? That won't look good for them either.
For Lily and Faith.
Yes, another one of us to erase from the books.
Bye-bye. That's a stock trip sound. You can hear that in Quake, first Quake game. A few other places, too. The Woodland Luxury Apartments, one day later. Epilogue. Is that him humming?
Oh, hi. Oh,
that's you.
Sheriff Bigby. Great to see you. I don't know if you remember me.
I know who you are, Flycatcher. You worked at the Woodlands for how many years now?
Flycatcher.
I think I've lost count. Are you gonna come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay. Great.
Someone mentioned a flycatcher.
This fucking line.
Hans. Jack Horner. Grendel.
Oh, Mr. Wolf. Flycatcher left his keys.
Can we talk?
Listen, Snow, can we talk? I wanted to...
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this.
So
we'll
formal.
Talk later, okay?
Mr. Wolf, Sheriff?
Good morning, Miss White.
You're late.
Good morning, Bluebeard. Another entry. A new order, Snow White in charge. With Crane out of the picture, Mayor Cole has officially appointed Snow White as Director of Operations and Deputy Mayor in his absence. Okay, so wherever Nat King Cole is, right, can still appoint people. Many would say this promotion is a long time coming, since she was instrumental in the establishment of Fabletown and personally ensured that many fables made it to the New World safely. She's been doing the work of deputy mayor unofficially for years. So now it's officially. We got two entries left. See if I get at least one more one.
Someone's gonna see you, Colin.
Nice. A pig carrying a six-pack. Right. I wonder if pigs eat hops. Or would eat. Ah, Web and Muffet Market. Little Miss Muffet there. Oh, right next door, too. Is that our apartment building?
I'm going! Jesus!
We You're only out. Have like 5 minutes.
And carry me for fuck's sake! I don't give a shit!
Put him in there so people don't see him.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Morning, Sheriff.
How can you see?
Nice fucking day. Shit! Just don't so, grab that, would you?
Don't be so dramatic.
It's just a farm. You don't have to be so dramatic about it.
Just why the hell did she have to send me and me boy away, huh?
The Book of Nod.
You promised me I'll get another chance. But Miss White said I had to go up to the damn farm anyway.
I tried.
Wait, Sheriff Bigby. I have something.
Aw.
You know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
Can you give this to Miss White, please? Dad says there's no time to say goodbye, so... If you could bring it to her, she was nice. So...
What is it?
What is it?
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best.
The insect collection.
It's a willow beetle.
Willow
That's
beetle.
A big one. They're cool, because when they're little, they have these pouches.
She'll
that
love it.
Squirt juice at you if you touch them.
Ugh.
I'm sure she'll love it.
She said it was pretty.
We're about ready to head out.
What's it like at the farm? I've heard ogres live there, and they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
They're not gonna do that.
We have to go. I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
You'll be safer there.
Don't worry. You'll be a lot safer there. There's plenty of space to run around, and a nice river nearby, so you can swim all you want.
Even in daytime?
Yeah. You don't have to worry about the Mundy seeing you. It'll be nice. Come on. It won't be so bad.
Wish you could tell
have
them ogres won't eat them.
Before?
No. Some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves, so you wouldn't know, would you?
We're
Just
all set.
What I've heard.
Bye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, TJ.
Hey, Bigby. Where's your friend, Colin? Where's a fucking pig?
Must be missing.
I don't know. He must have run off.
Bullshit.
Toad is suspicious of you. Funny. He's not a bullfrog. He's a toad. But he does say bull, you know, a lot. We got another entry. Only missing one. Probably won't get another one. Sheriff Bigby. After fleeing the homelands, Bigby Wolf spent many years wandering through Europe, with a fable colony quickly developing in the New World. Snow White and Feathertop? Tracked down the wolf and offered him passage to Fabletown. He agreed, and Snow cut him with a lycanthropy-stained knife to give him the power to change into human form at will. Snow White and Fable... Lycanthropy-stained knife, okay. Bigby became sheriff of Fabletown under King Cole's administration, but because of his violent past, many fables didn't trust him, and he was banned from ever setting foot on the farm. To this day, he struggles to redeem himself in the eyes of the community. Indeed. Well, I think he's come a long way towards gaining their trust now.
Saying goodbye?
Bon voyage. Nerissa? It's raining. Careful, your tail might come out.
Hi.
Hi.
You still the ribbon on.
You're still wearing that thing.
Oh. Yeah. I guess I am. It's not easy to forget.
I would be afraid to take it off.
I think I should be able to. It's just...
I understand.
It's okay. I get it.
Listen, I came here because I have to tell you something.
Comic Snook.
What is it?
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily. Not sure where to start.
Start at the beginning.
Faith, Lily, and I, we had this plan. We were gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good. But then Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together. The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out, I had no choice. You have to understand. You've seen how they kept us quiet in that place. Can you imagine the lengths they'd go just to silence someone who had physical evidence?
Narissa, just tell me what happened.
I freaked out, okay? I thought if I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
You what?
So I told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us.
And then he killed them.
I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
We're trying to protect
you were
them.
Just trying to protect them.
Yeah. Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the Crooked Man. But then, oh God.
Touch her arm. She noticed that.
I don't know what happened, but that night at the club, Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us. We had committed treason. And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie...
Wait, so Georgie told you all this? Not the Crooked Man? Back at the well, you said...
I know what I said.
But it wasn't the truth, was it?
What does it matter? I know the Crooked Man did it. So what if it wasn't the whole truth? It was true enough.
You shouldn't have lied, though.
So you think that makes it okay to lie?
I know he ordered their deaths. I wasn't gonna let him get away with it because of a stupid technicality. Especially after... that night, after Faith. I tried to warn Lily, but she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep.
I've been wondering, well, why would people... I was kind of wondering that during all this, but I don't get a lot of chance to talk, you know, unless I do this. I was kind of wondering, well, yeah, that makes sense, you know, the ribbons were removed and they were killed, but then why, like, the Crooked Man ordered it or he didn't, but why would someone leave the heads, like, and who did it? Did Georgie leave the heads at the apartment? But she did.
I walked her over here, and I left her, just hoping that maybe if I couldn't save them, could at least save
the
rest
of us. So I would notice.
You were trying to get my attention. So you started all this.
I just pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time. The Crooked Man was counting on that. When we suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way.
Oh,
we just
world stinks.
Fade, like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith or Lily. Nobody cares about us. Not really.
Sorry you had to do that.
I'm sorry, Narissa. I'm sorry that's what it took to get me to pay attention.
It'll be different now. You'll make things right. You and Snow.
I don't know. Seems like no matter what I do, it's just not enough for her, or anyone. I just can't win with these people.
I know it might feel that way, but they need you, Bigby. Both of you. You two make a good team. The way you look out for each other, and look out for us. You don't see that a lot these days.
I don't know where we stand.
I don't know where we stand anymore. Things are just different.
Huh. Things are always different. Look, Bigby.
Yellow brick roadhouse.
After everything you've done for us, maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you, none of this would have happened. You
True.
Listened. when no one else would. You knew when to show mercy, and you brought justice to this town. Finally. Because you brought the Crooked Man in, everyone saw who he really was. So from where I'm standing, you did the right thing. You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep because I knew if anyone stood a chance against the Crooked Man, it was you.
Well, but done some good.
At least done some good here.
You've changed this place. For better or worse, Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you.
I wonder what would have happened if I had killed him, the Crooked Man.
You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
There goes that line again.
That's I need to tell you something.
I have to tell you something.
That's what Faith said.
Like we've met before.
You're trying to place me.
You like my ribbon?
Do you like it?
Faith wore one too. Would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom.
They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
He said he wanted to run more tests. I hope you find what you're looking for.
Go after her. Is that Faith?
I'll see you around, Wolf.
Wait, who is that? If her head, if she's saying the same stuff Faith said, so her head, whose head is that? Whose head was left on the thing? Is she Faith glamored to look like Nerissa? But how did Faith survive? What the hell is it? Ugh. My mind is swimming now. Alright. 68.6% of players killed Georgie. Rather than let him die a slow, painful death. Did you give the Crooked Man a trial? 89.6% of players brought the Crooked Man back alive. I gotta watch a video. I'm sure there's a video out there of Bigby just killing the Crooked Man. That'll be interesting to see. And then the way everything changes afterwards is gonna be quite a lot. How did you punish the Crooked Man? Really? I'm in the minority here. 38.6% of players threw the Crooked Man down the witching well. I wish I knew the other stats. How many chose to have him imprisoned and how many chose to just rip his throat out. Basically, those were the three options. Did you accept TJ's gift for Snow? Well, duh. The 1.5% of players that didn't accept it? You guys are jerks. Yeah, 98.5% of players decided to accept TJ's gift for Snow. Last words to Nerissa. Well, I am at least somewhat in the majority here. 54.8% of players said, I hope I've done some good here. Huh. So who the hell is she, really? Special stats. Oh, cool. This was, once again, now the shortest episode. Each episode gets shorter and shorter. You realize that? Beast, you lied to him about seeing Beauty outside the apartment. Because, Beauty, you promised her you wouldn't tell Beast that you saw her outside the apartment. Keep your promises. You impressed her with your detective skills. Bluebeard, you fought him after the interrogation. Butcher, you offered him protection at the business office. Colin, you helped him to avoid the farm. Crooked Man, deceased. You took him back to the witching well. You tossed him down the witching well. But is he really dead? You don't see him die. And if the witching well doesn't have a bottom, I mean, I guess eventually you can die from being smacked around the sides just from falling uncontrollably. But I don't know. D. You confiscated Dee's money while he was in custody. That's right. Faith, deceased. You gave her money after the fight with the woodsman. Georgie, deceased. You smashed up his place. You took money from Georgie's safe. Greenleaf, you offered her a job. Gren, you drank with Gren after Lily's funeral. That was the one cool time with Gren, for very short-lived. Holly, you pretended to be woodsman while she was passed out. Yeah, that was funny. Jack, You reported him to Snow for burglary. Snow, you brought him along. You brought her along with you to the trip trap. You promised to bring the crooked man back alive, and I did. Tiny Tim, you chose to wait for him. Toad, you stood up for him when Snow wanted to send him to the farm. Wow. What do you think, guys? Now I'm going to be looking up things for who is Nerissa really? That was Bloody Mary. It has to be. I'm just putting two and two together here. Well, there were all these photographs in the factory. The Crooked Man's hideout. Of him talking with Faith. So, if she was hiding somewhere on a rooftop or alleyway or something, then Bloody Mary, I think, was the one taking the photos. And she heard what Faith said to him, what Faith and him were saying. So at least this time, she was glamored to look like Nerissa. That's what I think. But why? Why do all that? Just to screw with him? But I don't want it to be like that. I mean, there were some genuine moments there with him and Nerissa. Can't really trust anyone with this glamour crap. There's no, like, easy way to tell that someone's glamoured, you know? It's like, it's not like you could hold up a special lens and look through it. Ah, yo, that's really so-and-so. That would be interesting if they had something like that. So that's the only thing I can think, is then what happened to the real Nerissa? Is she still around? I don't know. Pick up a graphic novel today. What happens if I hit continue? Goes to this. Completing chapters. So yeah, in order to unlock these, you have to play the game over again and choose other choices. But I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Hope to see you guys in another Let's Play. I really enjoy the game. I will be playing The Wolf Among Us 2 whenever it finally comes out. At the time of this recording, it's in development, so I'm excited. We'll get to rejoin Bigby again. And I won't have to wait as long as some people. Because it'll be, yeah. This came out in 2013, I think. So, yeah, 6 years later. So thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope you really enjoyed it. Let me know what you think of this story in the comments below. I really enjoyed it. In my opinion, one of the best of the Telltale games I've played, and I've played quite a few. So, I'm really impressed. Alright, see you guys in another Let's Play. Thanks again for watching, and always, seek adventure.